Paul, you can see there's evidence of replication of original body marks or body assembly markings from the factory, and this would be when they restored it, whatever year that was. We have no idea on that, but it looks like with the new bolts and the areas you can see here, spring tags along with ball joints have been replaced. The original ones were welded, so you can see here that these do have bolts in them, so this has definitely had new ball joints put in it. The brake lines have a DOT marking on them of 1003, and I believe to my recollection that would be 2003, 10th month of 2003. Some more paint daubings that they put on the tie rod ends, replicating original assembly. Obviously by now those factories would be, those factory markings would be gone. Steering hoses, steering clamp area for the power steering ram, all appear to be in excellent condition. The rotors look good. We took this wheel off so you could see that. And in addition, the caliper appears to be very good. And you can see the thickness of the pads. They are very new. I don't know if they're dated or not. I believe they do usually have a date code. And I can't see it, but they're very thick, which would indicate to me that they haven't been on there that long, that's for sure. But good indication of a well-done job at some point. Wiring horses into proper grommets. Again, we're just taking the left front here to give you a shot of the effort that must have went into this when they originally did it. Also up here, of course, as you're aware of, that battery door on the air-conditioned cars on the left side, and that appears to be very factory. Okay, now we're looking at the left rear frame and the opening for the left rear wheel well, and I believe that all that indicates the same thing. Again, you can see where they were trying to replicate original pencil stencil marks from the build. And you got the ground straps properly installed for the radio. You can see the straps running up there for static. Body mount cushions look new, certainly not worn at all. So which indicate that I would say that that certainly was replaced. All the bushings look good. And we'll take some other shots underneath the car itself, but just letting you see this lower control arms and the shims, still all very clean. Paul, I'm going to try to throw some low light on the trim tag. Hopefully you'll be able to see this, and I'll move the light a little bit because we have no way of knowing how it's going to camera up. But there's the date code above, and then of course the style trim codes and body and paint. And we'll move over to the VIN tag, which you can see. And that VIN tag appears to be correctly mounted. I've seen them before, believe me, when they're not. And this appears to be correct. And giving you something here to digest and be able to view for a few seconds there. Okay, Paul, we're now looking at the right-hand door latch. I'll go over and look at the left one as well. But they appear to have been replated, or they could be original, but they're in very good condition, no noticeable wear. And as you know, that's where you do get a lot of wears in those. Same with the step plates here that we're shooting. Look good. The plates themselves, six screws. The actual latch out here on the door, striker plate, looks good. No sign of wear. And we'll go over and catch the left one while we're doing this. Same here, a little grease on it. But certainly not worn any. And move in there if you can, Pawn. Same on this side. Yep. Okay. Ultra flash. Okay, trying to show you a little bit of the underneath where the engine clutch housing is. Now, I haven't done anything to wipe it down, so I want you to see actually what is there. It's pretty dried. Right around here, you can see. I mean, there's evidence of oil film, but it's not dripping, and that's why I did not want to wipe anything off. Just to let you kind of see this, come around here, on the front here. Front seal appears pretty doggone good. You're always gonna have some seepage, but we haven't even tried to tighten anything or wipe anything off. Did not want to do that. Okay. We're now shooting back the right rear half shaft. You see they did some more paint, daub markings, redepicting the originality when it was built at the factory. But the spring looks good, U-joints look good, rubber bushings on the shocks look good, and again, all the brake lines look great back here at the back. Okay, spare tire carrier appears properly mounted, and as I peek in there, I see a brand new tire. I haven't opened it, but maybe I can look here and tell you. Doesn't say, but it is a nice new tire. Lock on the back. Everything appears very dry underneath here in the back. Hope this is helping you. Okay. We'll shoot the left side for you as well. You can see the half shaft and the U-joints appear very good. Okay, we've been told that power brake unit cars originally equipped with power brakes have a riveted retainer. You can see the rivet there holding the retainer which these two bolts go through. Come around the back side, you can see that through here. The retainer is actually riveted to the body. Okay. It appears the correct 55 amp alternator 11006941100694. Casting number on the intake appears to be 3894382. 3894382. There's the block casting. I believe it's 309-4351, the Tonawanda T on there. And as you notice, we did replace the spark plug wire assemblies, putting the correct shielded cable on them.